Hey there people, it's Danny from Conscious Calisthenics here. So in today's video, I want to talk about the worst time to work out when intermittent fasting, which I've never talked about in any other video before. I have talked about when the best time to work out is, and if you haven't seen that video, I put a link for it up above. So yeah, I thought this is quite an important thing to share with people because I've never talked about it. And if you're training at a time that is the worst time to work out with intermittent fasting, it's going to stop you from getting the greatest benefits from combining both of those things together, because it has been shown through many scientific studies out there, which you can do your research up online into them, that if you combine exercise at the right time with intermittent fasting, it will give you the greatest benefits from intermittent fasting, such as the increase in testosterone, the drop in insulin, the increase in human growth hormone production, and an increase in glucagon production, which is a fat burning hormone, and all these other benefits as well. Because when you do the exercise alongside the intermittent fasting, the exercise increases all of those benefits that I've just mentioned that you get from intermittent fasting. When you are not working out at the worst time to combine exercise with intermittent fasting. So yeah, the worst time to work out with intermittent fasting is after you have eaten. Because first off, when you eat, insulin will start to go up, glucagon production will go down. Also, the full benefits of human growth hormone and testosterone going up are going to start to massively be diminished. And if you're someone who wants to get the greatest benefits from intermittent fasting, this is something you don't want to do, because you want to maximize the benefits that you can get from it and increase the duration of the benefits as much as you possibly can. So then you can get the best weight loss benefits, or if you're someone that wants to gain muscle mass, then get the greatest muscle growth benefits. And also, what's happening, your body is in fact burning up all of the food that you have consumed as a fuel source whilst you're training after you have eaten, instead of your body burning its own body fat as fuel. So if you're someone that wants to sustain a low body fat percentage and get the greatest benefits for reducing body fat percentage, this is a big no-no. And also, what most people are going to find, due to a very specific reason, is when you eat food, your body is using up a lot of energy to digest that food. So what I would find, and many other people, if you are then eating food and training afterwards, you're not going to have as much energy to train as hard as you possibly can in the gym, and you're just not going to get the best workout that you can possibly get and do the best that you can within it. So for me, I just would not be eating my meal and then going to train, because it's just not going to give me the best benefits from the workout that I'm going to be doing, because I'm just not going to be able to push myself to my limits so I can get the greatest benefits from it. So for this reason, I just would not recommend this whatsoever, and all the other reasons as well. So I would personally recommend that you do eat your meals after you have either trained or later in the day, because all of those increase in the benefits that I mentioned early on with combining intermittent fasting with exercise are going to be sustained for about an extra 2 to 3 hours after you have exercised. So this is why I've mentioned in many other videos before, if you can refrain from eating and wait for around that time period, it could give you even greater weight loss benefits or even muscle growth benefits. And you do not need to be concerned whatsoever about losing muscle mass after training whatsoever, because there's so much scientific research that you can look into online that shows that intermittent fasting actually preserves muscle mass. And one last thing I want to add is, when you've consumed a lot of food, you ideally want to be resting and not be in a stressed out state and not moving around a lot and working out, so you can maximize the absorption of the foods and the nutrients contained within it, and so you can have the best digestion and elimination of the foods that you have consumed. So if you're someone that cares about optimizing your health and your digestion and making yourself feel the best mentally and physically, so for that reason as well, on top of all the other ones, it's just something that I'm not going to recommend, as I mentioned a couple of times in this video. So yeah, that's it for this video. I'd like to hear your own personal thoughts on what I shared with you in today's video, and share your own experiences with intermittent fasting and training. What time do you like to train, and have you experimented with other times and seen any different benefits of training different times? Or are you someone that eats a lot of food and then goes and train? Or yeah, just let us know anything around your whole schedule with intermittent fasting and training, so other people can see what you're doing and maybe they can learn something from you. Maybe I can too, because yeah, I may be personally not drawn to eat after food due to all the reasons that I have mentioned, but this isn't necessarily what everyone is gonna want to be doing. So if you have any questions, leave them down below and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. If you like the video, like it down below, give us a thumbs up. If you don't, give us a thumbs down, and please share this video with anyone else that you think would love to hear about what I shared with you today in relation to the worst time to work out when intermittent fasting. And if you haven't already, click that subscribe button down below to receive a lot more informational videos from me on specific subjects such as intermittent fasting, one meal a day, calisthenics workout and progression videos, what I eat and do in a day videos, and all different types of videos to share an abundance of information to help you go in the direction of learning the right things so you can actually gain and maintain the body desire, the fitness levels and the energy levels as well, like I've managed to, and many other people that have followed my information through my YouTube videos and also coaching clients that I've worked with around the world. So if those type of videos sound good to you, make sure you click the subscribe button down below and you click the bell notification button next to the subscribe button, otherwise YouTube will not notify you of when new videos are uploaded, and I have new ones coming almost every single day. So as always, stay happy, stay healthy, and enjoy the rest of your day. Peace.